This is part two. George Buster Rhymes, KVCI.blogspot.com. No, on July 18th, as usual, the event was a whiteout. As far as the news media is concerned in South Georgia and North Florida. That means that this historical event could be lost from the archival record of South Georgia as if though nothing happened. But I know you all appreciate somebody capturing these historical events in our community. And I'm forever grateful to God for allowing me and others to capture what others apparently want to keep hidden. On July 18th, Edward DeBose was in town as a reflection of Walter White back in May of 1918. And this historical event must be one day recorded in the Quitman Museum and in other museums around the South Georgia area. Without this information, coming generations of our children will have a false image of reality. And with all of the technology and all of the truth and lies and misconceptions and bamboozlement that we spread around the world, that we are the land of the free and the home of the brave, and free presses and freedom of speech is supposed to run rampant in our community. But we know very little about what happened to Earl Evans. That's police officer Earl Evans over in Quitman. The Wootons. And many other people that have died, but nobody have been brought to justice. Much like the 13 deaths that happened during the week of terror that we know about. We talk about heritage and we talk about the Confederacy, but very few people want to talk about the real historical archives of the past. We don't know about the deaths in Thomas County, in the city of Thomasville. We don't want to talk about the deaths, 30 deaths in the Lyons County Jail since 1994 to 2009. And they are not even subject to the Open Records Act, we are told. Yet, our local newspapers in South Georgia, the state of Georgia, and around the nation seem to care more about a cat or a dog or a rat or a squirrel trapped in a garbage can than human life being wasted away for whatever reason. We won't talk about the deaths in Madison, Florida, Perry, Florida, but yet we claim to talk about heritage. To Mr. Edward DeBose, state president and national board member of the NAACP, I thank you, my beautiful brother, for making your way down to South Georgia and carrying on the struggle of Reverend Martin Luther King Jr., Ralph Abernathy, the Reverend Joseph Lowry, and others. But I must ask the question today, where are the followers of Jesus Christ, Mohammed, son of Amram and Yochebed, Moses, Buddha, and the rest of the bunch? Where are they? Quitman and Lyons County, Georgia, is no different from any other small rural towns across America. But the question is, Oprah Winfrey, where are you? The Honorable Bill Cosby, where are you? Louis Farrakhan, in the Nation of Islam, where are you? you with the money that could bring a newspaper or a television station or a radio station down to the South Georgia area. We know we have radio stations in Valdosta and Lowndes County and in Quitman and all around, but they will not address the issues. They will not address the issues on a daily basis like Cedric Cawthorn and Bernard Robertson did on WJEM, the number one gospel station, nor like Al Parson, the owner of the Lake Park Post, Lee Touchland, Charles Moore, Mac Rose, and others who knew the importance of running waters. We talk about Moses. We talk about Jeremiah. We talk about Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, but we won't go. We talk about Ezekiel preaching to dry bones in the valley, but we won't give dollars to support those men and women who tell the truth today. It is like we buried our heads in the sand, like the land, the sand, like the legend concerning the ostrich bird, and we pretend that we're in heaven. But the water of truth is not running through our stream. Yet we can go to church on Sunday and holler, talk about Jesus. Go to Jumu'ah service on Friday, but we don't even know any Muslims in town. We don't know if there is any followers of the son of Amram and Yoshebel in town, unless it's dealing with the money. But when it comes down to standing up for the least among us, like Jesus and the rest of the gang, everything gets silent and the water stops upstream, and so we don't hear the sound that we hear here today. All because apparently we have fallen under the spell of the Leviathan. But I watched in the eyes of the people in Quitman and Brooks County the other night, and I saw a burning sensation in their hearts. They are committed to bringing about a change. I see them standing strong with the Quitman 10, but I did not see a lot of pastors there, and I can only ask why. I can only ask why. We give our monies apparently to the wrong type of pastor. Jesus was a pastor that took on the governments of his day. The lies being told today is that we should not get involved in politics. As the waters run in the stream, I'm here to tell you that every decision you make is a political decision. When you decide to go to the bathroom, that's a political decision. When you decide to get up in the morning and take a bath or a shower, that's a political decision. When you choose to put on some deodorant, that's a political decision that will affect everybody that you come in contact with for the day. That political decision was made in the Senate and the Congress of your own head. And so it is in this life. You say you go to church and you don't want to get involved in politics, and you talk about separation of church and state. Where would the church be if there wasn't a state with a landmass? Where would the state be if there was not a church? Where would the church be if there was not a state? They are intertwined together. And did not Jesus take on Cephas, Pilate, and Herod in his day? And was they not the equivalents of the president and kings of yesteryear? Was not David a man who was after God's own heart, the ruler of his day? Where do they get these lies that they try and indoctrinate and incarcerate us for their own gain? Sometimes I question, how did we call ourselves Christians in the first place? I repeat, how did we get or become Christians in the first place? For the man Jesus, knew absolutely nothing about Christianity. And I am a man of average intelligence. I've studied the Bible, the lost books of the Bible, the Egyptian Book of the Dead, the Torah, the Holy Quran, and I've asked for books of the Indian people. And I read everything else I can get my hands on, but Jesus knew nothing about Christianity, nor did Christianity come from his lips. And so we say we are Christians. We say we are Muslims. We say we are members of Judaism. But before all these names was crystallized and laid aside in our particular persuasional groups, God just told Adam to obey me. He told Adam to love. And whether you know it or not, Jesus taught the same thing. He taught love. So where is the love for your neighbor? So if I was going to be a Christian, I would try to crystallize myself with true love, wherein I would want for my neighbor that which I want and have for myself. That's where we are today, my friends. And so, Elbert DeBose came to Quitman to stand on and beside the Quitman team. Thank you, my beautiful brother. I'm determined to let the world know that America may just not be so free as we thought when it comes to freedom of the press and freedom of speech. And so, I'm going to leave you now. But in conclusion, I want you to hear the rest of the story. Why do you give your money to pastors and other people who see your brothers, your sisters, and your own children going to hell, dying, working every day in a state that is an at-will or work state where they can fire you for good calls, bad calls, or for no calls at all, and you say absolutely nothing about it, nor do your pastors, because somebody have indoctrinated them and incarcerated them to convince them that they can't be involved in politics? Yet you listen to Hagee and the rest of the crowd, those in power, speak on every level they want to, criticize the president, call him a donkey, a jack, any dirty name that you could think of, as if though God made a mistake in creating that beautiful brother. As if though they can't understand the scripture when the Bible says, speak ill of no man. The Christians are silent. And silent gives consent. Silent gives consent. People have questioned me. Brother Rhines, why do you speak so boldly? I don't speak boldly. I just want to live, and I want others to live. I want my neighbor to be treated like I want to be treated, like I want my children to be treated. I don't want to be enslaved. I don't want my children to be enslaved. I don't want your children to be enslaved. I don't want to be mistreated. I don't want to be ignored by the news media, the television, the radio, and the newspapers. And I don't want my children to be ignored by the television, newspapers, and radio. And I don't want your children to be ignored by the radio, television, and newspapers. I want equal access to equal jobs and a quality education. And so I want my children the same thing, and I want your children to have the same thing. And this is the teachings of Jesus. Jesus didn't just sit in the church and holler hallelujah and fall down on the floor and talk about how good he is, and then go out and feed some of the poor folk and give them a barbecue turtle egg or a chicken gizzard, and then boast themselves up about what they're doing for the poor. If you want to do something for the poor, ensure equal justice under the law. Want for your neighbor and work for those who are working for you. Support the people, support the truth speakers. Don't support the wicked. This is the day we're living in, brothers and sisters. This is the day you part in. This is the day You are tricking your children and sentencing your children to jails and prisons, which is a calculated system to incarcerate and eventually terminate human life as we know it. Yes, our legislature in the state of Georgia should be voted out of office if they cannot get rid of this at-will to work state. Too many people are suffering under that law. And too many of us are living in fear and won't speak out against it. Now, I say to you, I'm gonna let you listen to the waters and then we're gonna close out. Isn't that water peaceful? Doesn't that sound so peaceful? There's something about water. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. And what a beautiful creation God made. Now we gotta make something other than hell, confusion, and fear for our children. Take a stand, my brothers and sisters. Join the NAACP, the SCLC. And if you don't join any organization, begin to stand up for what you know is right. Get rid of fear, for God did not give us a spirit of fear, but of power, love, and a sound mind. Let us love one another. Let us respect one another. Men, don't abuse your women. And when you see somebody else abusing your woman, stand up on their behalf. Don't let everybody kick you around and treat you like you're three-fifths of a human being. Go back and study your ancestral heritage as Black African Americans and discover that we were the pyramid builders. Our ancestors get the credit because it is the truth. We were the architects, the craftsmen of yesterday. But we were hit in the head and brought a westerly course and buried in a shallow grave in North America. And many men has come to try to resurrect us from the dead. And that day will come. And if God pleases, we will resurrect others in the process, as Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King has so richly said. May God bless you. May heaven smile upon you, for it will. On behalf of KVCI.blogspot.com, Brother Ryan saying, stay in touch. Whitman 10, state representatives of the NAACP in the national office. Peace be unto you. May God ever, forever bless you. And to the Honorable Reverend Joseph Lowry, we wish you the best in the future. Along with Gabrielle, the People's Agenda, the SCLC, the Congressional Black Caucus, the Urban League, and all freedom fighters, ACLU, we appreciate all of you who take a stand on behalf of the people. Bye-bye. Be gone.